According to the latest market report of the Uganda Communications Commission, at least 11.3 million mobile money accounts remained inactive in the 3 months between January and March 2023. This means only 26 million mobile money accounts out of the 37.3 million are active.
There are so many complicated procedures that make it difficult for claimants to get that money. And we hear money is put on dormant accounts. You can imagine if money was put on the dormant account 25 years ago, since 25 years ago, like when MTN started.
It's upon this background that the Shema South legislator Professor Elijah Mushemeza seeks to move Parliament to do away with complicated procedures which deter claimants to claim mobile money that remains stuck on dormant accounts.
How much money is on the dormant account? What will be the fate of that money if the claimants have not been able to get that money? Because you die, you have your PIN number, has not left a will, and you see, that is a lot of accumulated money. So all these issues, the ICT committee has taken them on and have appeared as the first witness.
Details from the Bank of Uganda indicate that the value of money held in inactive mobile money accounts was 27.2 billion shillings as of September 2021, but reduced to 13.6 billion shillings by March 2022. Mushemeza is concerned that so many people die and leave a lot of money stuck on their mobile money accounts, but relatives can't retrieve the money because they don't have PIN numbers of the deceased.
In Uganda here, there are also companies that have been formed as middlemen, what are popularly known as distributors. They are also complaining they are never paid through their contract. This is an issue that needs further investigation, and even the government would be interested to see whether companies are paying taxes through that kind of transaction.
Under the National Payment Systems Act 2020, the central bank is mandated to declare a mobile money account inactive if it doesn't conduct any transaction in at least 90 consecutive days. If the account holder does not reactivate the account within 6 months after it's declared dormant, the account is blocked and any balances thereon are sent to the central bank. The Parliamentary Committee of ICT is considering Mushemeza's petition and they expected to meet Bank of Uganda next week.
So that our people, our customers are not cheated. And you know, we still have gaps in terms of having a consumer protection and competition laws. But the international practices which we could go by so that our consumers, we're also consumers, I'm also a consumer.
The former Makerere University political science don also wants telecom companies to stop charting Ugandans by terminating usage of data bundles on grounds of expiry. The professor also wants Parliament to find a way of enabling artists to benefit from the callerback tunes. He says telecom companies exploit artists by using their craft with very little revenue paid back.
The artists are complaining that their songs are used in caller tunes. In some countries like South Africa and others, a lot of money is generated, and musicians get a percentage for their royalties.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.